Jayo Prabhupada Jai Prabhupada Jayo Prabhupada Jayo Prabhupada
Jaya Prabhupada Jaya Prabhupada Prabhupada Jaya
Jayo Prabhupada Jai Prabhupada Prabhupada Jayo Prabhupada
Jaya
Prabhupada, 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 Jai Prabhupada. Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada.
Jai
Jaya Prabhupada, Jaya Prabhupada. Prabhupada, Jaya Prabhupada. Sri Guru Charana Padma Kevala Bhakti Satma. Sri Guru Charana Padma Kevala Bhakti Satma. Bandhumoe Savadana Mate. Bandhumoe Savadana Mate. Yahara prasade bai hey baba toriya jai Yahara prasade bai hey baba toriya jai Prapti hoya hoyte Krishna prapti hoya hoyte Guru Mukha Padma Vakya Chite Te Koriya Aikyo Guru Mukha Padma Vakya Chite Te Koriya Aikyo Arna kori o mane aso Arna kori o mane aso Charane rati, eise utama gati. Charane rati, eise utama gati. Guru charane rati, eise utama gati. Jai prasade pure sarva asa Jai prasade pure sarva asa Chakudan dilo jai jam jam prabhu se Chakudan dilo jai jam jam prabhu se
Divya Gyanira Prakashito Divya Gyanira Prakashito Prema Bhakti Javaita Avija Vinasayate Prema Bhakti Javaita Avija Vinasayate Vairagaya Hara Charito Vairagaya Hara Charito Sri Guru Karuna Sinu Adhama Janar Bandhu Sri Guru Karuna Sinu Adhama Janar Bandhu Sri Guru Karuna Sindhu Adhama Janar Bandhu Lokanath Lokarajivana Lokanath Lokarajivana Ha ha Prabhu Kora Doya Deha Mora Ha ha, Prabhu kar doya, deha mora parchaya. Ha ha, Prabhu kar doya, deha mora parchaya. Devayas gushukti bhuvana. Sukribhuvana Duya pad loila sarana Jayo Prabhupada 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 Jayo Prabhupada Jayo Prabhupada, 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 Jayo Prabhupada. Nitai Gaur Haribo, 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 Nitai Gaur Haribo. Nitai Gaur Haribo, 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 Nitai Gaur Haribo. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Sesa sunyavadi paschacare satarine Yeah. Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Shiva Sari Gaura Bhakta Vrinda
Chaitanya Nityananda
Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadhadhara Shiva Sari Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama.
Jayo Radha, Gopinath Radha, Gopinath Rare. Jayo Radha, Gopinath Radha, Gopinath Rare. Jayo Gauranitai, Jai Gauranitai, Gauranitai, Jayo Gauranitai. Jayo Jagannath, Jai Jagannath, Jayo Baladeva, Jayo Subhadrama. Jayo Jagannath, Jai Jagannath, Jayo Bala, Dev Jayo Subhadra. Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada, Prabhupada, Jayo Prabhupada. Nitai Gaura Haribo, 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 Nitai Gaura Haribo.
Thank you.
books.
Hare Krishna. Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Jai Radha Madhava
Kunja Bihari.
Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Jai Gopi Jana Ballava Giribar Dhari. Jai Gopi Jana Ballava Gopi Jana Ballava Giribar Dhari. Jaya Gopi Jana Ballava Yashoda Nandana Braja Jana Ranjana. Yashoda Nandana Yashoda Nandana Braja Jana Ranjana. Yashoda Nandana Yamuna Tira Banachari. Yamuna Tira Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Jai Radha Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama. Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna. Hare
Krishna.
Hare Rama. Hare Rama. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama. Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna. Hare Rama. Hare Rama 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 Jaya Jaya Prabhupada 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 Jaya Jaya Prabhupada Jaya Jaya Prabhupada Jaya Jaya Gurudev 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 Jaya Gurudev Jaya Jaya Guru Nitai Gaura Haribol Haribol বল হরি বল হরি বল গৌরা হরি
জং বিষ্ণুপাদ পরমহংস পরিব্রাজকাচার্য হিজ ডিভাইন গ্রেস এসি ভক্তি বেদান্ত স্বামী শ্রীল প্রভুপাদজী মহারাজ কি জয়। ইস্কন বিবিটি সংস্থাপক আচার্য শ্রীল প্রভুপাদজী মহারাজ কি জয়। জগৎগুরু শ্রীল ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী ঠাকুর শ্রীল প্রভুপাদজী মহারাজ কি জয়। আনন্দ কোটি বৈষ্ণব ভক্তবৃন্দ কি জয়। গ্রন্থরাজ শ্রীমদ ভাগবতম কি জয়। সম্বিত ভক্তবৃন্দ কি জয়। নিতাই গৌর প্রেমানন্দে উঙ্গ জ্ঞানতে মিরান্ধস্য জ্ঞানঞ্জন শলাকয়া চক্ষুরুন্মীলিতম য়েন তস্মৈ শ্রীগুরবে নমঃ। নমো অং বিষ্ণুপদায় কৃষ্ণপৃষ্ঠায় ভূতলে শ্রীমতে ভক্তিবেদান্ত স্বামিনিতি নামিনে। নমস্তে সারস্বতি দেবে গৌরবাণী প্রচারিণে নির্বিশেষ শূন্যবাদী পাশ্চাত্য দেশ তারিণে। হে কৃষ্ণ করুণা সিন্ধু দীনবন্ধু জগৎপতে গোপেশ গোপিকা কান্ত রাধা কান্ত নমস্তুতে। তপ্ত কাঞ্চন গৌরাঙ্গী রাধে বৃন্দাবনেশ্বরী বৃষভানুসুতে দেবী প্রণমামি হরিপ্রিয়ে। বাঞ্ছাকল্পতরুভ্যশ্চ কৃপা সিন্ধুভ্য এব চ। পতিতানাম পাবনেভ্যো বৈষ্ণবেভ্যো নমো নমো। নমো মহাবদান্যায় কৃষ্ণ প্রেম প্রদায়তে কৃষ্ণায় কৃষ্ণ চৈতন্য নাম্নে গৌরত্বসে নমঃ। জয় শ্রীকৃষ্ণ চৈতন্য প্রভু নিত্যানন্দ শ্রী অদ্বৈত গদাধর শ্রীবাসাদি শ্রী গৌর ভক্তবৃন্দ। হরে কৃষ্ণ 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 হরে হরে, হরে রাম রাম রাম। ওং নমো ভগবতে বাসুদেবায়। ওং নমো ভগবতে বাসুদেবায়। ওং নমো ভগবতে বাসুদেবায়। হরে কৃষ্ণ। শ্রীমদ্ ভাগবতম 9th ক্যান্টো চ্যাপ্টার 23 ভার্স 22। ধর্মস্তু হয়সুতো ধর্মস্তু নেত্রহ কুন্তে পিতা ততহ সোহঞ্জি অভবত কুন্তে মহিষ্মান ভদ্রসেনকঃ। ধর্মস্তু হয়সুতো নেত্রহ কুন্তে পিতা ততহ সোহঞ্জিরভবত কুন্তে মহিষ্মান ভদ্রসেনকঃ। Senaka. Translation, the son of Hayaya was Dharma, and the son of Dharma was Netra, Netra, the father of Kunti. From Kunti came a son named Sohanji, from Sohanji came Mahisman, and from Mahisman, Bhadrasena. Up to 38. Yeah. Yeah. I'll speak on the purport. Okay. Okay. So up to 38, end of this chapter, there is no more purports. Only Sukhdev Goswami mentioning their names. Great pious persons, their devotees, their names. Because in particular destiny, a particular dynasty, Krishna will come, Jadu dynasty, Krishna will come. So yesterday we are discussing, I can read the translation, then we can discuss something. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, the Super Soul, is in the heart of all living entities, descended in his original form as a human being in the dynasty or family of Yadu. Yadu had four sons named Sahasrajit, Krushtha, Nala, and Ripu. Of these four, the eldest Sahasrajit had a son named Satajit, who had three sons named Mahaya, Renuhaya, and Hayaya. And in that purport, Prabhupada mentioning, yesterday we are hearing, the yogis and the jnanis, the mystic yogis and the impersonalist, they cannot understand the absolute truth as impersonal. They can understand the absolute truth as impersonal or localized, but although such realized souls are above ordinary human beings, they cannot understand how the supreme absolute truth can be a person. Yogis, jnanis, they are not ordinary persons actually. One cannot be a yogis unless he controls his senses and mind. To achieve perfection in any yogas, in jnana yogas, in hatha yogas, in bhakti yogas, we have to control our senses, our mind, our material activities. But what is different between jnanis, yogis and devotees? They are trying to control their senses, and we are also trying to control our senses. They want to achieve perfection in yoga, in jnana. We also want to achieve perfection from bhakti. So what is different? So they are trying to best to control their senses by their own strength. This is the difference between jnani, yogis and devotees. This was a statement from Sri Ram. There is a discussion between in Ramayana, although not in Balmik Ramayana, in Ramcharitmanas, there was a discussion between Narad and Ram. Because Narad once wanted to marry. He was a brahmachari. Whole life he was a brahmachari, but he wanted to marry. And he went to Vishnu. Please, whole life I just serve you. I never ask any boon from you, but I want to marry. Vishnu suddenly became astonished. Do you know why? Narad wants to marry. And with very apologizing mood, humble mood, no, I want this boon, I want this boon, please you sanction. Because this come out of little pride. Narad was performing some severe austerity. At that time, Kamdev came. You know Kamdev, but how can you say? Kupit. He came. Somewhere we are discussing, because he have arrows, 5 arrows. So unless we serve Madan Mohan, Krishna, unless we pray sincerely, very difficult to control over Cupid. Very difficult. Only by his mercy, because he's Madan Mohan. Only he has power to conquer Madan, lust. So we are discussing that thing in one moral instructor mentioning how Madan Cupid using his arrows. He always, his duty, this is, how can you say, he want to test us whether we are pure or not. It is his duty, not his fault. So for the poor people, he using one arrow. Those are very poor. Those are middle class people. Yeah, just earning and earning. They have not enough amusement, material. For them, Kamdev using 2 arrows. For poor, 1. For middle person, 2. For those are how can I say? Yeah, middle person, 2. And those are Vidyarthis. How can I say? The students. For the students, he used 3 arrows. And for bhogis, those want to enjoy only. For bhogis, Cupid using 4. And for sannyasis, Cupid using 5. Yeah? You just mentioned? Because he want to test all sannyasis, everyone. This is his duty. This is seva. So Naradwaj is like sannyasi because he was performing some austerity and Cupid came. If you're jnani, yogis, they're not ordinary person at all. By controlling their senses, they want to achieve their perfections. But devotee also want to control his senses. But process is different, totally different. And this discussion was going between Narad and Sri Ram. So Cupid came and shoot 5 arrows, but Narad was so absorbed in Krishna consciousness, he never disturbed. Unless we absorb in Krishna consciousness means chanting, hearing and seva. This is one type of madness. Actually, Krishna consciousness is nothing else. This is spiritual madness. Like you can see material people, they are mad. For money, they don't care anyone. Sometimes they neglect their family, neglect their body. They're just absorbed how to earn money. They're greedy. Those are, how can you say, addicted, smokers, drunkards. They don't care their bodies. They don't care to anyone, father, mother, property. They're addicted. Addiction. There's madness. And Krishna consciousness is one type of madness, spiritual madness, real. Yeah. Holy. We have to observe in Krishna consciousness. Then we can get some test. So he was totally mad, Narad Muni was, in Krishna consciousness. Kamdev fell. Lastly, Kamdev paid obeisances. And when he was returning, Narad Muni started to laugh. Why conquer Cupid, Kamdev? Then immediately came and approaching to Brahmaji. Father, you know? I conquer Kamdev. And Brahma, not saying anything. Brahma is big expert manager in 3 worlds. He is a devotee as well as a manager. It is very difficult to manage
temple or manage anywhere, your family also. But Brahma is such an expert manager, only by his devotion he is managing three worlds. This is a devotional power. You imagine, in ISKCON we have many devotees, many systems, JBC, all things. But Prabhupada, he is only manager. He was manager, he was spiritual master, he was founder, he was everything. He is maintaining whole world by spiritual power. Brahma is like that. Expert manager. He knows my son will be in problem. Why he developing such proud, although he conquer Kamdev? Why is developing proud? But not said anything. Brahma is very expert. What to say, what not to say. Then went to Sibaji, his brother. He said, brother, you know, because when you get success, this is the nature of mind. When you achieve some success, this success is coming from Guru and Krishna. The success is not coming from our, how can you say, by our intelligence, our effort. No, it is coming from Guru and Krishna. But we don't want to give this credit to Guru and Krishna wholly. This is the problem. This is the spiritual problem. It is more danger than anything in this world. More danger. When you achieve success and at that moment, give all credits, give everything to Guru and Krishna. And you are working on behalf of Guru and Krishna. And keep this thing in mind is very difficult, very difficult. Practically, sometimes if you are not in proper consciousness, pride will come. Pride will come. So to become a true follower of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu means your life is just like a puppet, a doll in hand of spiritual master. That means we are discussing that thing. Although you are living, but you have to lead your life like a dead body. Like dead body, his hand, you can move anywhere. Puppet, you can dance him like that. And real Krishna consciousness life is like that. Wholly dependent on Guru and Krishna. No independent life, and always praying, then arrangement will come. And whatever success will come, you will never develop some pride. Because you know who I am. Who I am. So even our urine, our stool controlling us. You cannot, according to your desire, you can go to bathroom. Nature, what in English said? Nature is calling, huh? Nature is calling you. You cannot call nature. We are so powerful. But all, when credit is coming, oh, I am doing all these things. Shivji told, Shivaji is very devoted. He knows the secret. He is Mahajan. Narad, don't speak anything to anyone. Okay, you conquer Cupid, but don't say to anyone. And specially don't say to Vishnu. Because by his power only you conquer. Don't say to Vishnu. But Narad was so, how can you say, excited, went to Vishnu and paying obeisance. And told, Vishnu, you know, Prabhuji, by your mercy I conquer. Only saying your mercy, your mercy, your mercy. But inside, this abhiman is there. Why perform such a severe austerity? I defeated Kamdev. Then Vishnu came to know, oh, my son developing, my devotee is developing some pride. This is Nijajanasmaya Dhunsanasmita Bhavasakhet Bhavat Kinkarismano Jalaruhanana Charudarsayam. This is Krishna's blessing. Gopi is praying. This is Krishna's real blessing. When pride is coming and Krishna putting us in some trouble, curse is pride. This is Krishna's real blessing. But we mind don't want to admit it. Why I just failure in my duty? Why this is happening? But this is Krishna's blessing. Unless Krishna check our mind, unless trouble will come, we cannot pray nicely. If we achieve success in material field, day by day prideness will come, even in spiritual field. And to remind one thing, this success is coming by the mercy of Guru and Krishna. Krishna giving so much troubles because we have no other way than to pray Guru and Krishna. He putting you in such a situation. This is a real blessing. So Vishnu said, okay. He think he already conquered his. We are discussing about Jnani and Yogis. Why they are not understanding? Even they are not ordinary persons, but why they are not understanding Krishna? Absolute realized soul above ordinary human beings, but they cannot understand how the supreme absolute truth can be a person. Why they are not understanding? Although they conquer their senses, conquer their mind, but they are not depending on Krishna. They are not depending on Krishna. They are not praying to Krishna sincerely because Krishna is very powerful. Very powerful. Only jnanis, yogis conquering their mind, they have some realization about super soul, about Brahma. But they don't know Krishna's real feature is Shyam Sundar. 200 forms, Shyam Sundar, Gopavesa. All Krishna like to wear, how can you say? Coward boy dress, Gopavesa. Krishna never want, like, how can you say, we are wearing so many opulent dresses, huh? Yeah, Krishna don't like. Very simple dress, one dhoti, one chadar, bas. One stick, one flute. Even Krishna have no water bottle with his palm, when he was tending cow, he's drinking Jamuna's water. So simple, Krishna. Only tending cow. If you keep cow, then you have to lead your life as Krishna, simple life. Because cow, where cow will stay, you have to stay there. Krishna, very simple life. And it is not easy to understand Krishna. Because Prabhupada mentioning here, his Virat Rupa is not original form of Lord. The original form is Dibuja Shyam Sundar Muralidhar, the Lord with two hands and playing a flute. Unless Krishna shower his mercy to realize Krishna's real form. We are only chanting name. Why we are chanting name? We are chanting Krishna's name. In name, form is also there. Name prasputita hai rupa guna karma. Bhaktivinoda Thakur mentioning. Now we are seeing Krishna's, when we are seeing Krishna's deities, we are realizing, oh, Krishna may be like that, huh? Maybe like, Krishna is, today we are saying, oh, Krishna is very nice. Tomorrow saying, no, Krishna. Today Krishna not looks nice. We go to different temple. When we saw Krishna, oh, here deity is nice. There, oh, no, Krishna is not nice. But when we can see the real form, when we chant offenselessly, pure name, then from name, by chanting Krishna, Hare Krishna, you can see Krishna. Name prasputita hai. Out of pure name, manifested. What will manifested? Rupa. First Rupa. Krishna's form. Then guna. Krishna's qualities. And karma. Krishna's leela. It will manifest that. Not necessary to think. It will manifest. Automatically it will come. Because everything is in holy name. But these Mayavadis, Jnanis, Yogis, they are also sometimes chanting holy name. But they are not chanting holy name to realize Krishna. To serve Krishna. They want only perfections. In their siddhis. Eh? Yogis, they want some siddhis. Karmis, they want some pious activities. And Jnanis, they want to realize. Super soul, they want to meet super soul. Bas. They don't want to serve Krishna. Therefore, holy name not manifested everything. Rupa, guna, karma. Therefore, they don't know. They think Krishna is ordinary human being. They are reading Bhagavatam, Krishna Leelas. They think, why Krishna is doing like that? But we have to realize Krishna, first become yogi. Yoginam api sarvesam madgadantaratmanam. We are also yogis. We are yogis. Because our focus, our center of all activities, how to connect it with Krishna. We are bhakti yogis. Yoginam api sarvesam madgadantaratmanam. Among all set of yogis, bhakti yogi is top. Krishna is saying bhakti gita. We are discussing about Narad. Narad went to Vishnu. This is different between Jnani Yogi and devotee. And Vishnu created, when Narad returning from Vaikuntha, Vishnu created Maya. Within Maya, Vishnu created a kingdom. Nice kingdom. King is there, queen is there, everything is there. And king's daughter is there. And king is going to arrange marriage for his daughter. And at that time Narad Muni came. And Narad Muni, he was with Parvata. How can you say? Both are brahmacharis. They went to kingdom. They saw king just welcome and told to Narad, please. How can you say? In hand? So, you know, in horoscope, this is horoscope, this is? King said, told to Narad, please you saw my daughter's hand. Who will marry to my daughter? And Narad only saw, and this is Krishna's maya. You see how Krishna is powerful. Never, throughout his life, he never thought about a woman. Who is a woman even don't know. Once Urvashi also approached Narad. Narad, you are so handsome. I want to marry. Narad said, no. No, I don't want to marry. Why I will marry? Only in human body, in woman's body, only urine, stool, mucus, everything is there. I don't want to enjoy. Urvashi told, you know, I am not ordinary human. I am not ordinary woman also. You want to see? In my stomach, everything, how can I say? Aroma. Not blood, urine, stool. Nasty scent will come. Aroma is there. You want to see? You see. Then Narad said, mother. Immediately Narad said, Narad, very tricky. Narad, no. Narad said, mother, if within your womb, no blood, no urine, no stool, nothing else, aroma is coming. If I know before, then I may be born from your womb. So you are like my mother. Then a brahmachari, when approaching some Mataji as mother, how can Urvashi can say, okay, you marry me? Then Urvashi said, okay, I just relaxed you. Okay, you may go because you already approached me as mother. You want to take bath from my womb. But this time you see, Vishnu is putting Maya. Just see the hand lines of this daughter of king, immediately said, I want to marry. And Parvat, another brahmachari, he said, I want to marry. This is Krishna's Maya. And they went. Again went to Vishnu and said, Vishnu, whole life I never married. I never asked any boon. Today I want one boon. Please you have to give. What? I want to marry. You already married. Lakshmi is with you. Why I will be alone? Yes. All Rishis, Munis, within the Dandakaranya, you know Dandakaranya when Rama is moving? With Sita, within the forest, when they all watch Ram with Sita, they develop desire. Oh, our Lord is also. Why? Why we will be alone? Only performing a state whole life. Ram knows. Oh, they are my devotees. But you see, I married. How I am suffering? Okay, I have to talk to these yogis, to this my devotees. How family life is very severe. You have to cry. Bhagavatam is there. Then when Ravana took Sita and Ram knowingly coming to this Rishi's ashrams, knowingly. You know, all the munis, they keep one big stone in front of their ashrams. Why? They heard before Ram touched the feet of one stone and became a nice woman. So we should keep one nice stone in front of our ashrams. So when Ram come, if Ram touched stones, then they became woman, then we will enjoy. All saintly brahmacharis, they're keeping one big stone in front of their ashrams. And Ram came to know the intention. You see, only Krishna, Ram, they will save us. No one can save us. At any moment, the senses and the mind is just like snakes, furious snakes. Poison is there. Very difficult to recognize where is poison. Any moment. You see, snakes are moving here and there. Immediately saw human, immediately like that. Keep their hoods like that. Senses are there. Senses are same tendency. They have. Then Ram knowingly, when he was separated from Sita, knowingly crying in front of Rishis. Knowingly, when he saw some ashram, he crying more, how can I say, profusely more, crying, oh, where is Sita? And they remark, oh, before we thought family life is happy life, but now Ram is crying. And they said, no, we don't want to marry. And they brought these stones and throwing outside. No, we don't want now. Now, same thing happened to Narad. You're already married. I want to marry. Just give me boon. Why? Vishnu said, okay. What do you want? You give me a form as like as Hari. Hari means you, Vishnu. You should give me form. So you make me so beautiful like you. Vishnu said, okay, you go. Then Narad came to that king's assembly. Many kings came and daughter have to choose and Narad sit there. Narad was 100% confirmed that I will marry to this king's daughter because I already got boon from Hari. I already got boon from Vishnu. I will achieve same form as Vishnu. But the king's daughter going everywhere but not coming to Narad. But Narad was thinking, why is she not coming to me? I am the most beautiful person because I already took boon. But lastly, Narad is sitting there. She's not coming, not giving garland. Lastly, Narad, within many kings are sitting within Narad, Vishnu came in as a king form. And this girl, this king's daughter, take this garland and put in Vishnu. Then Narad became angry. And when Narad became angry, others are saying, Narad, why you became angry? Why this daughter not putting garland to me? Because I am the most beautiful among all the kings. Now all told, just go and see in water your face. Before there are not so many mirrors. Nowadays everywhere mirror. In bathroom mirror, in everywhere mirror. You go see your face within the water. Then Narad go and see his face within the water. And face was like monkey. Because Hari means lion, Hari means Vishnu, Hari means also monkey. Then went to Vishnu. You are selfish. You want to enjoy with your wife. Whole life I will become brahmachari. And chastise Vishnu like anything. I want to curse you. This was also Krishna's trick, Krishna's Leela, Vishnu's Leela. Because he want to test, how can you say, this separation mellow, Vipralamba Bhav. He was always with Lakshmi. He want, if once I separate with Lakshmi, then I can test Vipralamba. How can you say? Separation, love, out of separation. I can release it. Then he curses. Narada curses. I am crying. Because only thinking about this daughter, I am now separated. I am crying. My life is useless. And I am cursing you. You will cry for Lakshmi also. You will cry. And Lakshmi will separate from you. Then Vishnu said, okay, this is boon for me. I want this thing. I want to test separation. Love out of separation. I want to test it. Okay, in Ram avatar, I will enjoy. But when Ram avatar came, same Narad came. We are discussing. And when Ram was within the forest, and in separation, crying, and sometimes embracing trees, and where is my Sita? And at that time, Narad came. And Narad told Prabhuji, this is my fault because I caused you. Therefore, you are suffering. But still, I have one doubt. Why at that time you not allow me to marry? Still I have doubt. I never asked this question. But now you clarify. There Ram is saying, hey, jnanis, yogis, and devotees. In my vision, these jnanis and yogis, they are like elder sons. If you have elder sons, you are not thinking so much. Even you are not in your house, he can cook, he can go to restaurant, he can eat anywhere, he can work. But if you have a small son, always you have to look after. And Ram is saying, my devotee is just like my little son. So this is my duty to protect my devotee. You want to marry you. And this is my duty to protect you. But you see in history, many jnanis, many yogis, they married. I never stopped them. Okay, you are elder son. As you want, you can do. But my devotees, they are like my little child. So therefore, jnanis and yogis, although they are not ordinary persons, but it's very difficult for them to realize Krishna. But if we keep this mood like a small child, for a small child, it is not difficult to recognize his father. And to accept his father as father, he's not challenging his father. You are my father. And it is duty of father to protect child. We are devotees. We are totally dependent on Krishna. Why Jnani Yogi is not realizing like Prabhupada said? Therefore, out of many siddhas, the souls who have already realized the absolute truth, one may understand Krishna, who is exactly resemble a human beings. Why they are not realizing Krishna? They are so knowledgeous persons. Why? They are not depending on Krishna. Unless through body, mind and speech, you are surrendered at lotus feet of Krishna, and Krishna will not shower mercy, you cannot realize who is Krishna, because Krishna's leela is very funny also sometimes. Very funny. Funny. He looks, he sometimes performs some leela exactly like human being. Exactly like human being. Then everyone thinking, oh, he is human being. But actually, Prabhupada always used to say in West, man was made. Man was made after the image of God. Prabhupada always emphasizes on that point. And this Siddhanta is also in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Krishna rajata ka khela sarvato manar nilam narabaputahara swarup. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu mentioning. Narabaputahara swarup. Krishna's original form is human form. Among all leelas, human form of leela of Krishna, like Vishnu leelas, Narsingha leelas, Varaha leelas, but best leela, human form of leela, Krishna leela, Gopavesa, Venukara, Navakisura, Natavara. He was always dancing. You cannot dance. I can say, okay, you dance. You cannot dance. No? Artificially, you can dance. Like we are dancing. If mrudanga, someone playing mrudanga nicely, someone singing nicely, and our mind is little relaxed, then we can dance. Otherwise, we can dance. Because no natural happiness. And Krishna is full of full bliss. Always dancing. Many lilas. Therefore, if jnani yogis, they are hearing, they are studying all these lilas and thinking Krishna is ordinary human. One day, you see, one lila I can say about Krishna. Gurudev used to say this lila. Once, Krishna is within the house, but friends, always, all his friends coming to Nanda Bhavan, to Nanda Maharaj's courtyard, asking, where is Krishna? Wake up in the morning and coming to Nanda Maharaj's courtyard. Where is Krishna? Without Krishna, their life looks like useless. This is Krishna consciousness. And they ask to Nanda Maharaj, Nanda Maharaj, where is Krishna? Some friend is asking. Nanda Maharaj said, oh, I don't want to say about Krishna. Krishna is always playing. Sometimes going to Jamuna, just in the Jamuna beach, he's just dancing. He may be in Jamuna. Immediately another friend came. No, I just came from Jamuna. Krishna is not there. That means all friends searching where is Krishna. 24 hours it was their business. Then Krishna said, oh, maybe he like to climb over the trees. Maybe he in Bansiwata. Because Krishna like to climb over the trees and jumping sometimes. Maybe in Bansiwata. Another friend runs and said, no, I just came from Bansi, but Krishna is not there. Then Nanda Maharaj is creating doubt. Where then Krishna? Oh, maybe Krishna is now in Jabbat, in Vrishabhanpur, maybe in Barsana with Radharani. She is sometimes going there, maybe in Vrishabhanpur. Then another friend came. No, I just came from Barsana, Vrishabhanpur. Krishna is not there. Then Nanda Maharaj said, where Krishna? Then Yashoda Mata started to cry. Where is Krishna? All of his friends saying, no, he is not in Vrishabhanpur, he is not in Jamuna, not in. And Nanda Maharaj starts to cry, Yashoda starts to cry, and all friends start to cry. And Krishna was there in that backside of this door. And when all start to cry, Krishna just opened the door and saying, I am here, why you are crying? You see, he was hearing the whole story. But still he was watching what they are doing. Let's see. And when all start to cry, and Krishna saying, no, don't worry. I am in the backside of this door. Don't worry for me. This is Krishna. How can a yogi's jnanis, they can understand? How can they understand? He's super soul. No. Very difficult. Because they are not surrender. Even devotees. We are devotees. We can achieve our perfections by sadhana, by three things. Even we know Krishna is in personal form, but to get some relishment, some reciprocation, some personal relation, three things require. First one, you have to know tattva. Janma karma chame dibyam ebam javati tattvataha. Tattvas. Our Gaudiya Vaishnavism, especially, we are not storytellers. We are so many. You can see Prabhupada's lectures. Only some moral instructions, some moral stories, mostly tattvas. About soul, body, always holy name. Not stories like nowadays. Many stories, this story, that story. No, we are not storyteller. Our Krishna Katha is based on Tattva. Unless we know Tattva, we cannot clarify doubts. Like Nam Tattva. Nam is one Tattva. Guru Tattva. Vishnu Tattva. Like Krishna Tattva. Maya Tattva. Jiva Tattva. Unless we know, we can't clarify doubts. We are chanting holy name. We are chanting holy name. I'm sometimes thinking, oh, I have to worship Hanuman because I feel weak. That means you don't know. You don't know Nam Tattva. You are chanting holy name, but you are dependent on astrology. Huh? You are always consulting astrology. Why this is bad time, bad time? That means you don't know Nam Tattva. Then Nam will not give you mercy. You will be in a problem. Now you are like within the middle. Neither you are depending on holy name, nor guru, nor parampara. You are depending on now astrology. So Nam is one tattva. You have to know who is holy name. What is its power? So tattva is important. Three things required to know, achieve perfection in our parampara. First one is tattva. And second one is tathya. Tathya, tathya. Tathya means facts. Like here, how can you say? Radhadesh. Tathya is there, real fact. How this temple came, who came here, how to find it out. All these things are there. How Gopinath came, how Jagannath came. One history, real history. This is tathya. Why we are hearing so much every day about Bhagavatam, Krishna, Lilas? To know the tattva, secret behind it, and know the real fact. And third one is Lila Rahasya. Secret of Krishna's Lila. We want to know. Why Krishna performing these Lilas? Why Krishna performing? You can say, I can ask one question. Okay. Why Krishna stealing milk, yogurt from Brajvasis? Why? What is tattva behind it? Why stealing? In Nanda Maharaj's courtyard, Nanda Maharaj keeping so many nice cows. Among 9 lakhs cows, these cows are separated. Specially Krishna keeping, Nanda Maharaj keeping these cows for Krishna. Syamali, Dabali, they are not ordinary cows. They are not eating any grass, special grasses. Nanda Maharaj arranging space, Sugandha Truna Charani. Only they can eat, how can you say, the grasses, very nice aroma grasses they can eat. Otherwise they will not eat. Milk is pakka, nice milk. But why Krishna stealing? Why? Gopi jar chastising, still Krishna want to steal. What is tattva behind it? Because all these Brajvasis, before past life, they are performing severe austerity to serve Krishna. But they have no chance to serve because always Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda Mata serving. And they want to see Krishna personally every day. But Nanda Maharaj is a king. They are not allowed so frequently to see Krishna. So Krishna knows, if I will go to their house, they can see me. Without any hindrance, they can see me. So, and I want to steal yogurt, milk, just for their pleasure, to give pleasure to them. Every day they are complaining. Huh? If you complain, okay, this person is coming to my house. Okay, you go to police station. Why Brajavasis not went to Mathura? Not complaining near Krishna. Why they are complaining to Nanda Maharaj? And in front of Krishna, they are complaining. You know, the tattva is there. When Krishna standing nearby the Nanda Maharaj, all Brajavasis will come and complaining in front of Krishna. Your son is doing like that. And if he will become a king, he will become a thief. Better you control. And Krishna laughing and saying, okay, you are saying like that today because they know if we will say like that, then Krishna forcefully going to our house. They're complaining, let Krishna come to my house. This is tattva. If someone complains, don't come to my house, we will not go. But when they're complaining about Krishna, Krishna said, okay. And all Brajavasis know the secret. If he more complain, then Krishna will more come. They know. This is tattva. Therefore, always complaint comes from Krishna. So one day all Brajavasis come. Because Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda Mata want to control Krishna. Because sure, if he was so small and going to everyone's house and stealing, if he became king, then same propensity, he may continue same propensity. He will steal. This is not good. This said many things to Krishna. Krishna, this is not good, stealing. We have everything. We have milk. We have everything. Why you are stealing? Krishna saying, don't hear, mother. They are complaining unnecessary. Unnecessary complaints. Can they prove I am stealing? They can't prove I am stealing. Unnecessary they are complaining. Yashoda Mata saying, how all Brajavasis is complaining? Some fact is there. But Yashoda Mata also same time, Krishna speaks in such a way, as like as a human. Mother, why you are hearing? Why? They are envious to me. Therefore they are complaining. Krishna speaks so nicely, Yashoda Mata 100% convinced, my son is not stealing. And all Brajavasis be astonished. Yashoda know very well Krishna is stealing, but now he is admitting, no, my son is not stealing. Now one leela is there in Bhagavatam, Vishwanatha Chakravarti mentioning so nicely. We are discussing all these things. Why? Actually, it is very difficult unless you know tattva and tathya and leela rahasyas. Very difficult to realize Krishna. Why Krishna performing all these leelas? He is supreme personality of Godhead and same time he is charioteer. He is the supreme worshipper and same time paying obeisance to Bhishma Dev. He is just paying obeisance to Yudhishthira Maharaj. He is controlling whole Mahabharat, but beginning of every day, beginning before fighting, he is paying obeisance to Dronacharya, he is paying obeisance to Yudhishthira Maharaj, his devotees. He is paying obeisance to his devotees. How can you recognize? Very difficult. So once, more 5 minutes, I want to finish. Once all Brajavasis came, Gopis came and complaining, Yashoda, your son is stealing. Yashoda said, this is your fault, this is not my son's fault. If someone is stealing, before stealing you should give him, he will not steal. Before you should give, why you will steal? You have love for Krishna, okay, you give. He said, Yashoda, we are asking Krishna, please come to my house and take this yogurt milk, but he don't like. He don't like when we are giving, but he's stealing. But Yashoda is saying, you see, this much love. Yashoda has so much love for Krishna. He's saying, no, this is your fault. Still, this is your fault. He said, how? How this is our fault? We are giving, but he is not accepting. Rather, he's stealing. No, my son, he always sigh. If you give something, Krishna is sigh. You see how Yashoda's loves. He don't want to admit my Krishna have some fault. My son is very feels always shyness. Therefore, if you give something, he will not eat. So this is your fault. If you think Krishna is stealing, you should keep all these pots. How can you say? In the roof, hanging in the roof. You should hang in the roof. So Krishna is very small, he cannot climb. He cannot bring it. The next day, they try like that. All gopis, in India, they have some ropes. They keep mud pots and hanging over the roof to protect from cats. And Krishna went to see all in everyone's house. Now yogurt, milk, everything in the roof. Then he became angry. He said to Sudama Subal, hey, I want to burn everyone's house. Because Krishna became angry. All you Brajavasis perform so much austerity to serve me, but now I just personally came to accept your service. Now you are putting me in trouble. I have to climb over there. Then Krishna knows, he said to Subal, you bring one stick. Your stick are small stones. You bring small stones. With small stones, Krishna just throwing and make holes. And all coward boys, they open their mouth and just drinking. And whole rooms is just out of milk, yogurt. And when Brajvasis gopis came, then Krishna ran out. And next day they informed to Yashoda, you see, your son is doing like that, with small stones making holes and just wasting. They are not eating, just wasting my everything. Then Yashoda said, this is your fault. Still this is your fault. You may keep in a dark room. In a dark room, Krishna can't see it. Better you keep in dark room. Then they keep in dark room. But Krishna have one stone, you know? Krishna wearing one stone. This stone, if Krishna stand in front of sunlight, then stone have capacity to, how can you say, acquire lights. And Krishna use as, how can you say, like charger, torch light. And when Gopi is keeping within the dark room, Krishna bring the stone and like torch light putting, where is it? Still he found out. Then again next day they complaining. Yashoda, still your son find it out. Even we are keeping in dark room. Yashoda said, this is still your fault. You should keep someone as a security. You keep someone. Old men are, many women are, the men are there. Keep someone in the door so that Krishna will not enter. Krishna very clever. He knows. And knowingly, he went in backside and opened the cups. If you open the cup, then cup will go and drink milk from cows. When Krishna opened the cup, the security, the guards who is just watching the room, he's just running behind the cup. Then Krishna enter and finish everything. Then lastly, they came to Yashoda and they told to Yashoda, Yashoda, you see Krishna is doing like that. Still Yashoda saying, no, this is your fault. Better so many old men and women are there in every house. You just from two side, back side, front side, you just make them as guard, security guard. They can guard. And Krishna knows, Krishna collects some yogurt, some makhans, some milk from his own house and said to Subal, you bring it. And when these old women, they are sitting just to guard Krishna, Krishna going backside and smear cords, milks in their face and shouting, come, 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 you see, everyone blaming me that I am stealing, but all these old women, they are in name of as a security guard, they are eating everything. And all gopis next day came and complained to Yashoda. You see, your son is doing like that. Then all Brajvasi is saying, now we can't do anything because none of our old men, they want to just guard in our house because they already blame, Krishna already blamed them. Now, then Krishna came. He said, yeah. Then Yashoda said, why so many time you are complaining? Then Krishna said, mother, you know, because they are complaining so that I can go to their house. Only therefore they are complaining. Actually, I have no fault. If they don't want to give me something, why they are complaining to you? Why not they are complaining to Kansa? Let you go to Kansa and complain. I can see what Kansa can do. Then all Brajvasis start to laugh. Because they want to complain. Why? Why they want to complain? Let Krishna come and destroy all our properties. Because Krishna is our property. This milk is not our property. Yogurt is not property. Let Krishna come to our house. We can see Krishna. So how can a yogi's jnanis understand all these leelas? No. Only devotees. And who know tattva? Who know the secret of leelas? Only they can. Therefore Krishna is only meant for devotees. And the devotees who develop pure love, only they can realize. Okay, Hare Krishna. Jai Granthara Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Jai Gaur Nityanand Prabhu ki, Jai Sisi Radha Gopinath Lalita Visakha ki, Jai Jagannath Baldev Subhadra Maharani ki, Jai Sambit Vaishnav Bhakta Vrunda ki, Jai Srila Prabhupadji Maharaj ki, Jai Srila Gurudev ki, Jai Nitai Gaur Pramanande, Hari Hari Bol, Hare Krishna. Jai Srila Prabhupada ki, Jai. What is there? Let me fold down.